Vice President Hodge.
Thank you. I'd like to also thank everyone that has come out. I know some people have left, especially to the children. I think that people have talked about the specialness of Oakland and the level of activism that exists, we have a legacy of, and it actually begins with our young people. So I'm very appreciative of parents who are guiding and teaching their children around speaking and speaking for themselves and being self-determined. I have a number of questions. Throughout this past month and a half, this process has been about really acknowledging that, yes, we're closing schools, we're proposing to close schools, but we're also looking at transforming aspects of the district. And so I have been very frustrated because I haven't felt like we've been able to get into that part of the conversation, that there's this painful part of potentially taking some things away, but there's also this process that we can actually create some things. So we haven't been able to talk about this balance. And that's been a problem for me. There's so many things I could respond to from public comment, that the district is gentrifying Oakland. We're actually feeling the pain of that gentrification. Where are African Americans in Oakland? Where are our students? We can say they go to charters, but we also know that they don't live here anymore, and they don't go to our schools. So. But I won't keep going on that. I have questions directly for staff around, there's also this issue of transparency. During the summer, some of the affected schools, it seems as though all of our schools, when thinking about the strategic plan that was, we've been in process for the last 2 years, and we've had engagement with community and residents and business people, there was conversations at school sites about becoming K-8, and I heard Santa Fe speak to that. And I'm wondering whether or not we did the next step to go back to people and explain why they may not have been chosen to be a K-8 school, or why they did not become a part of a STEM corridor. It seems as though we engage in some processes, and often within our district, the leadership or staffing, some personnel changes. I'm just going to give us that something shifted, didn't allow us to communicate very clearly. But I think that I've heard over and over again, we should be given this opportunity. And from my understanding, during the summer and during the spring, these opportunities were actually placed in front of people. So some of the bashing that has happened around West Oakland about it being a part of a STEM corridor, I recall the engagement process. I recall community members being not understanding what STEM was, what was STEAM. You know, we've been making jokes about it, but it's been in our community and been in dialogue and conversation. So these are my questions back to what was then our process to go back to teachers, to go back to, seems as though we shifted principals in the midst of this. Did we really weigh out people's capacity to do this next process? And I have a lot of questions, obviously, about Burkhalter and Kaiser, to begin to talk about that. And probably the last thing is this, if we do vote to do closures, there is next step process around how we place young people and families into new schools and the student assignment office. I want absolute clarity and understanding around what that process is going to look like. Thank you.